cassoulet, duck and milk stew, was invented in Castelnaudary when they were surrounded by the invaders and there was nothing else to eat. So the mayor of the town, who was a woman, had the town crier going around and say, hey, bring everything you have in the center of the town right now. Bring everything comestible in the center of the town right now. And that was cassoulet. The recipe we're gonna do is the by the book D'Artagnan with the D'Artagnan kit. Very, very easy to do. You just follow the instructions on the kit. I'm going to show you the little variation, the shortcuts. We're starting with the beans, most important thing. The beans are from Southwest France. They are the coco tarbé, haricot tarbé. This bean, we think, because we're super snob in Gascony, we think that it's the best bean possible for cassoulet. Why? Because it has exactly the right width so that when you cook it all together for a very long time, half of them stays whole and part of them bursts and actually make the sauce and bind the sauce. This is why we're using this one. First step is to drain the beans. That's easy enough. You open this, you put it in a bowl, non-reactive, with water to cover, and you let it overnight, 12 hours, to soak. Next day, you drain the beans. Put the beans in another pot, add some fresh water, and then add all the stuff that we're gonna see here. This is at the stage I am right now. This cooked for approximately half an hour, 45 minutes. So, we take this, we drain it. You can put a little teaspoon of this too, the duck and milk demi-glace, that's just to add flavor to the water so that the beans will have a good flavor to begin with. So I'm going to use that type of a cassole. Otherwise, on the website, you have that huge one for 12 people. It's not more work because it's exactly the same recipe. It's simply that you need to have a big family. By the way, cassoulet keeps, so if you don't eat it the first day, you can continue to eat the second and the third. All right. Here are my 6 pieces of confit, right there. This is my ventrèche, I'm gonna cut it in little cubes. This is our liquid. This is what we're going to use. Don't use the liquid from the cooking beans, okay? To baste your cassoulet once in a while. Don't want to lose that fat. This is very good. So, we have everything here. So anything goes, as long as it's ceramic or earthenware, anything that goes in the oven, but you don't want the cassoulet to be taller than your recipient. That's the only rule. Now, this is a little bit of a secret, a big secret from Zizou Dufour, Alix, my daughter, godfather. And he used to own the Relais de l'Armagnac in Upéviol, and he had a very, very mean cassoulet, one of the best in the world, for my taste. So his secret, and he told me very late in his life, his secret is to take a little bit of the duck fat, to take one of those garlic cloves that you cooked that are soft, and to coat that kind of a mix there
all inside your castle. And that's going to give a nice je ne sais quoi to the whole thing. It will help the temperature going uniformly inside. It will help the taste and it will help the beans not being burned and stuck on the side of the on the inside of the cassole of your dish. Now we're ready to assemble. Let's start assembling. So first, a layer of beans. Nice layer of beans, okay? And the beans with the garlic, with the carrots, whatever was left, except the onion, right? Remember the onion planted with cloves you discarded? You put on the compost or you gave to the chickens already. All right, so you cover the bottom of the dish and that's easily recognizable, you know, once you put the spoon in there, because you're gonna need one piece per person to serve and have those two extra pieces for the fight, for the second run. I'm gonna put just a little bit of garlic sausage with this, maybe not all of them, but some of them, cannot hurt. Voilà. And some of the ventresh, not all of them, just some of them in the holes. This is a puzzle. You have to fit, you know, it's like your washing machine. See, that had a clove on it. All right. So, this looks pretty good. The sausages, like this. Okay, yeah, at least you have eight, so you know that you have two per person when you serve later. And then we're gonna finish with the ventresse. And the beans. Preheat your oven. 350 up to 400, no problem. 325, I mean, that's not the important thing I'll explain to you. And then remember this concoction that we organized. This is to make sure that it's not going to dry out in the first couple of hours of the cooking. So depending on how much you're going to put in there, you are safe for here I put half of it. Here I'm safe for a good hour. But you don't mind being a little soupy at the beginning. The last thing you want is to dry it too much. Okay? So, in doubt. Here we go. See you in an hour, just to check it out. Starting to look good. Look at that! So, this is starting to crust, and this is what you want. A good cassoulet will have a crust, and you don't need breadcrumbs to do it. Look, the beans are doing it on their own. You don't want it to dry out, so we're going to add some of that tomato paste, demi-glace water liquid in there. I'm gonna keep just a little bit to do that one more time afterwards. And just because I want, you know, those beans to really crisp a little bit on the outside, just putting a little bit of duck fat. That's it. That's 1 hour into it. Another hour and I think we're good. We're gonna leave it in there with that additional juice for another 20 minutes. Then I take it out, it is done. We can eat it right now, we can put it in the refrigerator and reheat it about 45 minutes or so. It's a big recipient for tomorrow or the day after or whenever. We can keep it like that in the refrigerator for 3-4 days before reheating if you need to. But I don't think it's gonna last 3 or 4 days, I tell you. It smells so good.
nice, nice, nice.